Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about integrated development of wildlife habitats. Now we know that for the conservation of wildlife, we are having a ministry called as MOEF, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, right? So this MOEF is having a division called as Wildlife Division. So the Wildlife Division of the Environment Ministry provides technical and financial supports to the state and the union territory governments for the conservation of wildlife. So the Wildlife Division of the Environment Ministry provides the technical and financial supports to state and union territory governments for the wildlife conservation. Okay, so for that we are having some schemes. So through these schemes, the Wildlife Division is providing financial and technical support. Okay, so the schemes like centrally sponsored scheme, integrated development of wildlife habitats, and also through the scheme, central sector scheme, strengthening of Wildlife Division and consultancies for special tasks. And also the wildlife provides supports through the grant in aid to Central Zoo Authority and Wildlife Institute of India, Dehradun. Okay, so through this grant in aids and also through the schemes, the Wildlife Division provides financial and technical supports to the state and union territory governments. Okay, so one of the scheme was centrally sponsored scheme called as Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat. Okay, so that is one of the important scheme which are aiming at wildlife conservation. Okay, so we need to know about Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat scheme, right? Now the Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat scheme, it's an ongoing centrally sponsored scheme. Okay, earlier under the Ministry of Environment Forest, we were having a centrally sponsored scheme called as Assistance for the Development of National Parks and Sanctuaries, and that was also a scheme under the MOEF, and that was added with more components. Okay, so that scheme called as Assistance for the Development of National Parks and Sanctuaries were added with more components and activities. That means it was modified and renamed as the Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat Scheme. So Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat Scheme was earlier called as Assistance for the Development of National Parks and Sanctuaries, and that was renamed and modified and added with some components and activities. And right now we are having Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat Scheme, and that's a centrally sponsored scheme. So this Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat Scheme is having three components. So we need to know about these three components. Now the first component is supporting to protected areas. So we are having the protected areas like national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserves and community reserves. Okay, so the supports given by the Wildlife Division will be given to the protected areas through this Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat Scheme. So that is the first component of the IDWH. Okay, so support to the protected areas like national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserves and community reserves are the first component of IDWH, right? And we know that wildlife is not only found in the protected areas, we can also see wildlife outside protected area, right? So we need to support the wildlife which are found in outside the protected areas, right? So that's why we are having the second component for this IDWH called as Protection of Wildlife Outside Protected Areas. Okay, so we have to support the wildlife which are seen outside the protected areas. So that's the second component. And the third component is recovery programs for saving critically endangered species and habitats. So we know that there will be lots of critically endangered species, there will be some animals which are facing more threat, right? So thereby it will be critically endangered category, right? So in order to recover that critically endangered species from their extinction, we are having the third component called as recovery program for saving critically endangered species and habitats. So we are not only saving the critically endangered species, we are also trying to support, or we are also trying to save the habitat of that animal. Okay, so that is the third component, and that third component is much more important. Why? Because it is specifically dealing with critically endangered species, and there are 21 species which are identified under this third component. Okay, so there are 21 species which are listed in the third component of Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat Scheme. Okay, so you need to study about that 21 species. Okay, so the 21 species are listed in the recovery program for critically endangered species, right? So some of the animals which are listed in this program are Asiatic lion, Sangai deer or the dancing deer, right? Then dugong, Gangari dolphin, Great Indian bustard, Hangul, Indian rhino, one horned rhinoceros, right, Ilgiri tar, vulture, swamp deer and red panda, right? So these are some species which are listed in the recovery program. So like that, there are 21 species which are listed in this program. So you need to Google on the 21 species and you need to study about that also, right? Because earlier only 17 species were there in this program, later only the remaining added, right? So UPSC can ask questions regarding species which are included in this program. So they might give some names of animals and they will ask you to identify the animals which are listed in this recovery program for critically endangered species. Okay, so you need to know about the 21 species. Now, the main activities which are supported under this scheme are, first one, management, planning and capacity building, anti-poaching and infrastructure development, restoration of habitats, eco-development and community-oriented activities. So, these are the main activities which are supported under the Integrated Development of Wild Habitat Scheme. Okay, so these are the main point you have to remember. So, the most important point you have to remember is these three components. Okay, so let's move on to the model question. With reference to the Integrated Development of Wild Habitat Scheme, consider the following statement. And first statement, through this scheme, IDWH, the Government of India provides financial and technical assistance to the state or union territory governments for activities aimed at wildlife conservation. So, that's the correct statement, right? Through this scheme, MOF is providing financial and technical support, right? So, first statement is correct. So, we eliminated D and B. Then second statement, the scope of protection of wildlife outside protected areas are excluded from this scheme. That's a wrong statement, right? The second component of the Integrated Development of Wild Habitat Scheme was giving support to the wildlife outside protected area, right? So first component was supporting wildlife within the protected area, okay? And the second component was supporting wildlife outside the protected areas. And third component was recovery program for critically endangered species. Okay. So that's why second statement is wrong. Right. So the answer will come as A, one only.